Hello and welcome to part 9 of the first of the 3 weekly lessons about Oracle JET. A key feature of JET is its library of components. In the second week of the weekly lessons about Oracle JET, we will focus specifically on the Oracle JET components, and you will learn how to use each of them in detail. In this part, you will be introduced generically to the workflow of integrating Oracle JET components into your Oracle JET applications. The Oracle JET components are all open sourced and available at github.com/oracle/oraclejet. Each of them is described in the online Oracle JET cookbook, which we will be using in this part of the course. In each case, a complete recipe consisting of the HTML view and the JavaScript business logic are defined and can be copied and pasted into your applications. In each case, JavaScript documentation defining each component is also available. In the demo that follows, you will be shown the online Oracle JET cookbook, the related JavaScript documentation, and how to work with the online Oracle JET cookbook. Here is the OJ chart that we discussed earlier in the course, using the new custom element syntax in the HTML file. And here is the data that is loaded into it from the view model. This is how the chart looks in the browser. Notice that when we change the type to, for example, bar, and go back to the browser, we now have a bar chart. What would be useful for this scenario would be to have a drop-down list that lets the user choose either bar or pie, and then switch automatically from the bar chart to the pie chart. The JET cookbook has a range of components, several of which could help us in this particular context. A simple solution would be to use the select component. Notice that as we go into the select component section of the Oracle JET cookbook, there are a range of different solutions that are provided. The select component has many different features, each of which are illustrated in different ways by means of recipes. The simplest recipe presents a list of different browsers. When a different browser is selected, notice that the text below the browser is automatically updated. We have an HTML section and we have a JavaScript section in the cookbook. This presents the view and the business logic of the component that we see in the browser. The info tab provides some basic information explaining how the particular recipe is to be used. Directly within the browser, you can tweak and update the component that you see displayed here. For example, right now we see a list of browsers, but what we would like is to show the user the possibility of selecting a pie chart or a bar chart. We can make the changes directly in the recipe, even deleting lines, and when the apply button is clicked in the top right, notice that the component is updated and that it works as expected. Now that we are happy with the data displayed within the component, we can copy the related tags and paste them inside of our HTML file. Notice that the value attribute refers to a property. Let's go back into the cookbook and find it there. The property will be named val. On the JavaScript side of the recipe, we find our property. We copy it, and you go back into the JavaScript side of our Oracle JET module and paste it there. Again, we see a KO observable, and we will initialize our KO observable with one of our two types, in this case, pi. We now have a property named val. Knockout will observe that property and update all references whenever it changes. There is one reference at this point to val. A final step is that we need to load the component that we are making use of. Here we have the reference to the component that we are using. We copy it from the cookbook and we paste it in our JavaScript file. Now, back in the browser, we see we have a drop-down list containing the data that we provided. However, when we switch from one type to another, notice that the chart is not updated. The reason for that is that the type is hard-coded to bar. What we would like to do instead is to set the type to the same property that we are using in our drop-down list. Not only do we want to refer to that property, but we want to do so in a very specific way. Notice that here we have curly braces, whereas for this property, we're using square braces. The difference between the two is very important. The two curly braces indicate that this is a read-write property, while the square braces indicate that we are dealing with a read-only property. In this case, we want to enable the user to change the val property by means of the drop-down list, and therefore we specify it by means of the curly braces. In addition, we want to bind the type attribute of the OJ chart to the same property. Now, the value attribute of the OJ select one component and the type attribute of the OJ chart component are bound to the same property. That property is set to be read-write so that the user can change it by means of the drop-down list. When a change is made by means of the drop-down list, the OJ chart component's type attribute will automatically be updated to the new value. As you have seen, curly braces denote read-write properties or two-way data bindings, while square braces signify read-only properties or one-way data bindings. Though you could theoretically use curly braces everywhere and make all properties read-write, practically what you are doing when you do that is setting listeners everywhere, which you don't need everywhere. So when you simply want to display the value of a property, use square braces. And when you want to ensure that you can change that property by means of a component, use curly braces. The correct approach with the chart in this case is to use square braces and curly braces for the drop-down list. Back in the browser, notice that when we make a change in the drop-down list, the chart is automatically updated as well. That is because the type property of the chart is set to the same property as the value of the drop-down list. Notice also that back in the Oracle JET Cookbook, in addition to many variations on the simple drop-down list, a link is provided to the related JavaScript documentation. All aspects relating to each component are defined in great detail with example code by means of the JavaScript documentation. Also notice in the Oracle JET Cookbook that you can see how each component looks on different types of devices, as well as on different platforms. By means of the Oracle JET Cookbook, you have a complete guide to each of the components that Oracle JET makes available, and you can copy and paste components directly from the Oracle JET Cookbook into your application after tweaking them live in the browser. You should now understand how to quickly and easily integrate Oracle JET components into your Oracle JET applications. You can treat the cookbook like a palette of components that can be cut and pasted into your applications without much work. In the second of the weekly lessons about Oracle JET, you will be introduced to each of the components and about the benefits of each in your enterprise JavaScript applications. Your homework exercise is to experiment with different components in the online Oracle JET Cookbook and learn how to integrate them into your applications.